remember Terry Funk telling me on the night I wrestled Norman the Lunatic, I think the pay-per-view was called Wild Thing, it was Ric Flair's 42nd birthday. How I got an invite to Nature Boy's birthday, I don't know. And everyone's kind of patting me on the back because I'd taken some big bumps. And then Terry Funk cuts a little promo on me about the angel and the devil. Cactus Jack, people want to talk about your bumps. Norman was the angel out there, but there was no, and he has this deep story about coming up to the devil lying in the gutter, and why are you there? The devil says, don't you understand? Without me, there is no him. And he says, Norman was that angel, and you weren't there for him. Son, or whatever, in order for those bumps to mean what they could be, you have to learn to put into another gear. And so now I have to, that's the primary thing. I remember talking to Sasha Banks. I call Sasha the architect because she puts together these just, they're matches, yes, but they're masterpieces, you know? And like she has the ability just to create these memorable moments. And I remember telling her, this was the most difficult thing for me because I saw a sense of myself in her because she is this, in some ways, shy, you know, unassuming person who has ability to turn it on like that. And I told her that was my biggest hurdle, was trying to become aggressive enough so that the stuff I did when it was time, now it's not just go through, get as little rudimentary heat as you can and go to your strengths. Now I've got to turn the aggression into strength. And now that I've got some offense that's looking more unbelievable, I go to Japan where they don't care how hard you hit them. You know, they're asking you to hit them harder. Steve, this is a formative moment in my life. I know I have the run in WCW, but I take a lot of pride in taking care of my opponents. But now I'm with Shoji Nakamaki in the second round of the Kawasaki Dream Tournament, which has come to be known as the King of the Death Match. And we've got a bed of nails, bed of nails. I'm going to drop an elbow on Nakamaki, who's underneath the bed of nails. And I'm up there, and I remember thinking to myself, I can take care of this benevolent human being under those bed of nails, or I can make this look good. And you know I don't curse very much, right?
No.
And I decide, I'm going to make this look good. Good. And that was a difficult thing for me to do because I always, you know, when I see him, oh, Danger Man, you okay? He's like, oh, good, good. You know, like, couldn't have been happier with the way it turned out. But that was a big thing for me to understand. I do have to get my stuff in there. And I had to come up with enough stuff that could be formidable looking, you know, playing to my strengths, which were few athletically, physically, as a heel. But by believing in the character and investing time in it, you know, I joke and say, like, you had these guys who looked, they were carved out of stone in WWE. And then I show up and I got the little buggy whip arms, right? You know, and it was like, those guys, that guy? Oh, yeah. Like, there was a question.
Do not miss my conversation with the hardcore legend, Mick Foley, right here on Broken Skull Sessions. And that's the bottom line.